In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this render image in 10 minutes. Let's create a UV sphere with 16 segments and rings. In edit mode, type 1 to vertex select. Let's select and move some of the vertices at the top. Please use proportional editing for some. Type G and Z to bring them up or down a bit. In object mode, Control 3 to subdivide and right click to shade smooth. Let's create a leaf mesh by using a plane. Control R to create a loop cut in the middle. I have selected two outer vertices and typed S and X to scale them inward like this. Let's subdivide this mesh as well. The idea is to select the edges in the middle and beveling them. Let's bring them down a bit first. I'll align the mesh's bottom end with the world center, and move the origin to the 3D cursor. We must move the origin this way, in order to easily rotate it later. Let's work on the middle part. In edit mode, type 2 to edge select, and shift select the two edges in the middle. The idea is to bevel the edges by pressing Ctrl B and moving the mouse wheel up once to add one more edge loop in the middle. In total, we need 3 edge loops in the middle. We'll select the middle one and bring it down to make the edge loop visible. If we bring the middle edge loop down a bit, then we'll see a clear line in the middle after subdividing the mesh. Let's work on the end vertex. Since this is a tutorial on creating an orange material, I'll just use a random green material for the leaf. If you want to make it look better, please find and use an orange leaf photo as the material. Let's work on the branch. I was going to use a cube, but changed my mind. Let's create a mesh circle instead. We could make it like this, but then we won't easily get the star shape at the bottom. If you don't see the mesh circle in the menu, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. We need 10 vertices. In edit mode, type 1 to vertex select, and checker deselect them. Scale them like this after that. Let's shift select two vertices and type F to connect them. Type A to select all, and F to fill. E to extrude. Let's type 3 to face select. I'll select the top faces and scale them like this. Let's extrude this face upward. Let's repeat the extrude, scale, and rotate to shape up the branch mesh. Let's subdivide. If you want to make the branch to look better, please use a photograph as a reference to build a better looking branch mesh. Let's attach the leaf mesh to the branch. In edit mode, I'll select the outer vertices and bring them down like this. Here are the full nodes for the orange material. The idea is to use the noise and bump it to the normal node. Please test the material by replacing the mix node with color ramp. Looks like the leaf is too small. Let's scale it. I'll move them up to align its bottom with the world center, and create a ground plane. I'll use the Node Wrangler add-on to add a random set of PBR texture images. I'll use the sky texture. This angle looks good. I'll turn off use nodes under compositing, and use 16 samples to render the scene. Please increase the sample amount, and use photographs for the leaf and the branch meshes to make them look better. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.